Robert from CTech again. Today let's talk about coding our own plugins for CTech TBD. First, download and install the ESP32 toolchain by Espressif. You can read how to do that on the ESP IDF webpage. Next, you have to clone CTech TBD from the GitHub repository. Update all submodules. And once that's done, you can build the program by using idf.py build. Let's have a look at the directory structure of the project. In the root directory, there are a lot of configuration files. The main directory contains files, for example, to manage the REST API for the web service, as well as the main audio thread. In the component directory, you will find everything which is related to your signal processing. So you see all the C++ classes for all the different sound processors. This is where you will put your own plugin code in the end. In the helper subdirectory, there are a lot of helper classes already, such as envelope generators, wave sources, and fast math algorithms. The SPI-FFS subdirectory contains all the data for the description of the web UI. This is where your own description file for your own plugin will go. It furthermore contains the web application itself, so JavaScript code is in here as well. The generator subdirectory contains files to auto-generate plugins from a template. This is where we go in the following. The first file we will look at is the mui-template.json file. We copy this file and rename it the way we want to call our plugin. Now this file in fact contains all the information for the web UI. So all the parameters which we want to see and edit are actually written here. We can also configure if this plugin is supposed to be a stereo plugin or mono plugin. You can write, for instance, also a hint which helps you when you choose your own plugin later on in the web application. Configure parameters as simple JSON objects. We are creating here a simple voltage-controlled amplifier, which will have basically just one parameter, which is loudness. You can control the loudness later on in the web application by simply clicking on the parameter or assign it to any external control voltage or the potentiometers. Note that the parameter here is basically just an integer value. It has a minimum value of 0 and a maximum value of 4095. We will cast this in our audio process to a floating point value. Note the ID parameter. This is the internal name of our plugin. It's not allowed to have any white spaces and it's case sensitive. This name will also be used for the C++ class in the end. Next, we will use the generator.js script to auto-generate our C++ classes, as well as a JSON file for storing preset data. In order to do so, change into the generator subdirectory, and you have to have Node.js installed. Start generator with just one parameter, which is basically your UI definition file, your JSON file. From this, the generator generates all the required files. The files the generator generated are, for example, the C++ classes and the preset file. Here we have a look at the preset file. This is the header file for your C++ class. It contains a lot of stuff. You can dive into it deeper once you get to know and love TBD. And this is the C++ class in which we will create our own plugin. So let's move towards this one. But first, we have to copy these files into respective directories. So all the C++ files go into components CTEX hard processor subdirectory, and the JSON files go into the SPI-FFS image subdirectory. C++ files are now in the correct directory, as well as the JSON web UI definition files. Now it's time to code our first plugin. Let's open the CTEX sound processor simple VCA file. That's where the process method resides. The process method is the method in which the DSP stuff is happening. It runs at audio frequency. Let's check out the data parameter. It contains the audio input-output buffer as float array, as well as the data from the control voltage, potentiometers, and trigger buttons. Let's use our web UI parameter loudness, which was an integer, and convert it into a float. For this, we simply divide it by 4095 as a float iterator. Next, let's iterate over the audio buffer. Note that there are already some parameters given for you, such as the size of the buffer. So we simply have to write a for loop to iterate all the values. The audio buffer in the data parameter is actually stereo data from both input channels. So we have to select the correct channel. For this, our class already gives us a nice parameter process channel, which contains the correct channel depending whether this plugin will be assigned to channel 0 or channel 1. So let's just multiply the input data with our float loudness parameter. At this stage, our loudness would only be modified by using the web UI. We want to modify it as well using CV control. So let's apply the CV data. Place an if statement to check if CV data is enabled from the web UI, and then simply assign it to the float loudness parameter. Audio sampling rate is 44.1 kHz. The control sampling rate is much less than that, approximately 1.4 kHz. So you may want to apply some linear interpolation here. Building our project is easy. IDF.py build flash monitor. The CMake build engine will automatically detect our new plugin. All build files will be generated automatically. We don't have to worry about anything. I'm speeding things up here because flashing is so slow. The firmware has been correctly flashed to our module, and we have access to the module through the web API. We can see that our new plugin is available, even with the hint. Check out, even the parameter which we have defined in the JSON file is available, together with the CV control and potentiometer control. Now it's time for doing a real test. We have assigned some pink noise to channel 0. And let's assign our simple VCA to channel 1. Let's now attach the output of channel 1, which is our VCA, to an amplifier, and use the output of channel 0, which is the pink noise, as an input to our VCA. We can hear that the noise actually is coming through. I can use the potentiometer to adjust the volume. And of course, we would like to modulate with an external control voltage, which has been attached to CV0. Thank you.